hair in the business. Where is it?
Behind the amante. That's correct. Here we go. All right. You just turn it up just a touch. Thank you. I'm just tall. We're back in action. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Welcome to the Dream Hotel here in Chelsea, New York City for the final press conference for the great fight card taking place at the Hulu Theater this Friday night. But ladies and gentlemen, before we begin, please, we'd be remiss to not mention the tragedies of 9/11 that happened 18 years ago today. So on behalf of Matchroom Boxing USA, DAZN, and Sky Sports, our thoughts and prayers go out to the victims, their families, the first responders, the brave men and women who lost their lives 18 years ago today. May God rest their souls. Thank you. So ladies and gentlemen, we're all very familiar with Madison Square Garden, the mecca of boxing. But the theater has its own great history. You know, originally opened in 1968, it was named the Felt Forum, named after Irving Mitchell Felt, the then president of Madison Square Garden. And over the years, it has hosted a great array of fighters and fights, from a young Mike Tyson to an aging Larry Holmes, a young Roy Jones Jr., to an aging Howard Davis Jr. It saw Vernon Forrest take the titles away from Shane Mosley. And this Friday, we've got a new fistic chapter as the rising star, Devin Haney, looks to inscribe his name in theater lore. A great co-feature, Featherweight Championship of the World, The Battle of Brooklyn, been brewing for a long time, Hardy and Serrano, a compelling heavyweight matchup with Kuzmin and Hunter, and an array of other great Olympians and young fighters, some even making their professional debuts. Magomed Rasul, welcome. Also, I do want to give a shout out to Kike Bermudez. I just want to say, many years ago, I used to train at a gym out in Bushwick, Brooklyn. And I remember an 8-year-old Kike Bermudez coming in there. And now Friday, he's making his professional debut at Madison Square Garden. So congratulations, Kike. And you know, there's one more fight I want to talk about on the card that I really like. It's Lethal Larry Fryers and Wesley El Bongo Cero Ferrer. It's, you know, back in the day, Madison Square Garden, the old Madison Square Garden, used to have the Friday night fights. And the legendary matchmaker, Teddy Brenner, I mean, he was infamous for just putting together wars. You know, back then it seemed that every New York neighborhood kind of had their own clubs and fighters that they supported, usually along ethnic lines. And the Fryers-Ferrer fight, it's a throwback fight. You know, Lethal Larry Fryers from County Clonus, County Monaghan in Ireland. Wesley Ferreira's from Panama, he fights out of Brooklyn. It's a throwback fight. It's a type of fight that thrilled fight fans for decades, and it's the type of fight that made Madison Square Garden the mecca of boxing. So ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, it's just a great fight card that we have on tap, and it all takes place at the mecca of boxing, Madison Square Garden, on Friday the 13th. So undoubtedly, we'll see some fighters be very lucky, and we'll see some fighters be very unlucky. So here to introduce you to everybody, the man that put it together, the president of Matchroom Boxing USA, Mr. Eddie Hearn.
Thank you, David, and thanks for this incredible turnout here today. As David said, couldn't be more right. Madison Square Garden, what a place. Whether you're in the theater or the big arena, this place just puts chills down your spine. It is the place for any young fighter to learn their craft and eventually headline the big arena. With Devin Haney, one of the most talked about young fighters in the world right now, I saw comments from him where he talked about he's no longer a prospect. And I think he's right. You know, I think it's impossible to say now he's one of the great prospects in world boxing because he's about to fight for the interim world title in a very tough fight against the unbeaten Russian Zaro Abdullayev, the winner of which will be the mandatory challenger for Vasily Lomachenko. I see Igis Klimas in the room here today, Lomachenko's manager. We want that fight straight after for the winner of the league in December. And this is now the big stage for both these guys. The prospect tags have gone, and it's really about cementing themselves now and their legacy in the sport as they move towards full world championships. David's right, the card from top to bottom is fantastic. Lou DiBella's here, we'll hear from him shortly. And the women's co-feature is just a fight that is probably one of the biggest in women's boxing. The co-main event now on this card, the Battle of Brooklyn, Heather Hardy against Amanda Serrano, is a thrilling fight that I think is gonna light up the theater at Madison Square Garden on Friday night. And for me, one of the top heavyweight fights of the year, Michael Hunter against Sergey Kuzmin as well. I think he's a brilliant, brilliant fight. Great to see two young heavyweight prospects taking each other on rather than waiting for a shot at one of the very, very big boys. Of course, this fight, as always, shown exclusively live on DAZN, and their schedule now is just absolutely breathtaking. Obviously, we're here on Friday night. On Saturday night, you have Munguia fighting in LA, you have Ryan Garcia, and then moving later on to the brilliant Triple G against Derevchenko on October the 5th. We have Usyk against Tyrone Spong on October the 12th from Chicago. Just a stacked card moving to the World Boxing Super Series, Regis Progress, against Josh Taylor on October the 26th. We got the one you guys all love, KSI against Logan Paul. Over 5,000 tickets sold already just on the pre-sale day in LA on November 9th. And I'm sure some big announcements coming your way over the next couple of days as well. We're going to hear from the man behind that schedule now, ladies and gentlemen, the Vice President of Communications for DAZN, Joe Markowski.
Thank you, Eddie, and thanks to all our friends in the media joining us here in New York this afternoon. As Eddie mentioned, we're about to embark on a tremendous 3 or 4 month period for DAZN here in the United States. The schedule we are putting together, and we're not yet fully announced with that schedule, is already one of the strongest in the history of the sport of boxing. It would be very easy to stand here today and look past this weekend at some of the names, some of the fighters, and some of the matchups to come in the next few weeks, in the next few months. And Eddie's mentioned some of them. The likes of Triple G, the likes of AJ Ruiz. Very shortly, we'll be making an announcement in relation to Canelo Alvarez's next fight. Huge fights, huge names, and a packed schedule starting this weekend. So we don't want to look past this weekend. For us, it's the start of a season of fight sports. Much is made of the season kickoffs for the NFL and the NBA in the United States. And historically, boxing's not been seen as a season of events, a season of great fights. We are putting that season together, and it starts this weekend at the Hulu Theatre at MSG in New York. So thanks to our friends at MSG, Joel and Sal, for their continued hospitality. And what a fight it is in traditional matchroom, Eddie Hearn terms, it's a stacked card from top to bottom. Eddie's right, no longer a prospect, one of the greatest young stars in boxing, and Devin Haney, and the latest challenge for him. And our continued investment in women's boxing, Lou will, I'm sure, talk to it, a tremendously anticipated matchup in Hardy Serrano. So we're looking forward to that. Top to bottom, the card's very, very strong. As I say, it's the start of a tremendous season of fight sports for us. If you're a fight fan, there's nowhere else you need to be this fall. Download DAZN, buy a subscription. We look forward to welcoming you starting this weekend. What's sure to be a fantastic few months of boxing on DAZN. Thanks very much.
Thank you, Joe. Before we start talking to the fighters up here on the stage, there's two fighters that we want to bring up, one of which is making his professional debut on Friday night, another one who is starting out his career as one of US's top amateurs. So I always like to bring him up here because it's very difficult when you first turn pro and you've got to speak in front of all you wonderful people, but it's very important for them to get this experience. Firstly, up from Camden, New Jersey, undefeated Raymond Ford.
How everybody doing?
Good.
First, I want to thank God, Matchroom, Eddie Hearn, DAZN, my team, everybody that's behind me and got me ready for this fight. Friday the 13th, you can expect speed, power, slickness, defense, whatever you want to call it. I'm going to show out, though. It's going to be a great show, and I want to say good luck to all the other fighters out here. And you're watching one of the top prospects right now, so keep a lookout for me. Thank you.
Obviously, the heavyweight division is on fire right now. The biggest of those fights coming live to DAZN on December the 7th when Anthony Joshua rematches Andy Ruiz in Saudi Arabia. It's going to be a huge, huge night all around the world for boxing. And this man actually, although AJ might keep me saying it, beat Anthony Joshua in the World Amateur Finals. He's a three-time amateur world champion. Ladies and gentlemen, making his professional debut on Friday, Magomedrasol Magomedov.
Hello everybody, my English is not good. First of all, I want to say thank you New York City for hosting, and thanks my management team and my promoter at home, Mushroom Boxing. I want to say English, maybe. Thank you. I'll show you fight, good fight.
Well done, Mega. Very good. Okay, there was a fight that was due to take place on this fight, on this card, for the WBA and IBF Super Bantamweight World Championship. Danny Roman, the champion, was injured a few weeks ago, but we're delighted to keep MJ Akmagaliyev on the card. For me, one of the top young prospects in world boxing. This fight will be rescheduled. It is a brilliant fight between a unified world champion, like I said, someone that is just starting out in the pro ranks, but obviously had an incredible amateur career. Vadim Kornilov does a brilliant job with these young fighters and World of Boxing promotions, and just the way they look after the fighters, the way they bring them through, not afraid to put them in early. You see that with other fighters, with not just Sergei Kuzmin, but Israel Madrimov as well. And MJ is another fighter willing to step up and fight for world championships early on in his career. Want to bring him up to say a few words, ladies and gentlemen, MJ Akmagaliyev.
Hello everybody. Assalamu alaikum. На этот бой я очень хорошо подготовился, на чемпионский бой. Бой с Дэнни Роман, но Дэнни Роман у него с плеча травма получил, но я надеюсь, иншаллах, скоро он вызовется. Надеюсь, скоро увидимся. Большое спасибо тренерам. Диол Дес, Антони Дес, мой промотор, менеджер, Эдгар Хейвен, Матчрум, Андрей Михайлович Бинский, Вадим Корнилов. Я думаю, скоро Дэнни Роман вызовется, и я буду с ним. Увидимся, и, иншаллах, к концу готов года, в декабре я буду с ним буду драться. Иншаллах, большое спасибо, thank you so much.
I had a very good training camp for this fight. This was going to be the biggest fight of my life. I trained very hard, and I'm happy that I'm still on the card, and I appreciate that. Dani Roman, in my opinion, is a champion, and he just, I deserve the fight. I've been waiting for this a very long time, and I hope that December we can make the fight happen, because this is what I want, and this is what I've been wanting for all my life. And I appreciate Matchroom, Eddie Hearn, World of Boxing, Andre Rubinsky, my manager, and all of my team, Gerald Diaz, Tony Diaz, Oleg Krolov, everybody who worked with me. And I'm looking forward to the biggest fight of my life soon. Thank you very much.
Thank you, MJ. 100% you will be rescheduled if you win on Friday night to fight Danny Roman in the very near future. Another young man who was a stellar amateur fighter, 2016 Rio Olympic gold medalist Daniil Yelusinov, who has already been unbeaten in professional ranks. He's got a proper Now we get into the exciting stage. We've seen him go through the gears and fight lesser opposition. Now we're going into unbeaten fighters, talented fighters, moving up to 10 rounds. And I think we're going to start to see the very best now of Danny Aryunusinov. His opponent, who is here to win, looking forward to this fight on Friday night. I want to bring up, say a few words firstly, Rashad Hicks.
I just want to say thank you to my management team, Jess Rubalo, Greg Cohen Promotions, also Kevin Thompson. I want to say thank you to Matchroom for having me. This weekend is a special weekend for me, being that I am prior service, I am ex-Army. I have served in a combat zone, and this weekend I'm coming from one combat zone to another, so you can expect fireworks. I know none of y'all know who I am, but you will at the Friday.
Thank you, Rashad. And now his opponent, the 2016 Olympic gold medalist, the undefeated Danny Aryunusinov.
New York City and Madison Square Garden, and my promoter Eddie Hearn and my management for this great opportunity at the Mecca of Boxing. I will show my skills and my intelligence on Friday night. Come and see me. Thank you.
Thank you, guys. We go now to what I call the three big events on Friday night, really a triple header at Madison Square Garden on Friday. Firstly, guys, let's be quieter back there. Diamante, I know you like to talk, but let's just keep you quiet, eh? Yeah? Good man, by the way, your hand in your notice. Right. It's a triple header, of course, and firstly, we're gonna talk about the big heavyweight fight. As I said before, every now and again, young prospects, not go back to that word prospects, these are top 15 guys in the world. Top 15 heavyweights are waiting for the big fights. They're waiting for Joshua, they're waiting for Wilder, they're waiting for Fury. But these guys have decided to fight each other to catapult themselves into that shot a lot quicker, mainly because they believe they're gonna win the fight. On one side, you have Sergey Kuzmin, an outstanding amateur, part of the World of Boxing team, Vadim Kornilov, Andrei Rybinski, who consistently put their fighters into tough, tough fights, willing to roll the dice because they believe in them, and they want to find out if they're the real deal. On the other side, you have Michael Hunter, another great amateur, trained by Haseem Rahman, one loss on his career, which was a great fight against undisputed cruiserweight champion, Alexander Usyk. He moved up to heavyweight. He's been a revelation at heavyweight. You know, he's looked unbeatable at times. He's got speed, he's got movement, he's got bundles of heart. This is such a great heavyweight fight between two great guys. Firstly, I'm going to bring up one undefeated fighter who is looking to stake his claim at a shot at the world heavyweight title from Russia, Sergey Kuzmin.
Здравствуйте, рад всех приветствовать сегодня здесь, в Нью-Йорке. Рад то, что снова я здесь буду проводить свой очередной поединок. Я к нему подошел очень хорошо, отлично даже сказал, прошел отличный лагерь свой. Вот. Очень рад то, что это событие произойдет в таком историческом месте, как Madison Square Garden. Вот. Благодарен своему сопернику Майклу Хантеру, то, что он принял этот бой, и то, что мы 13 сентября сойдемся на ринге, и он почувствует, что такое настоящий русский дух. Спасибо большое Эдди Хирну, то, что он делает такие хорошие события. Вот, Андрею Михайловичу Рябинскому, менеджеру моему Вадиму Корнилову. Вот, всем спасибо.
Happy to be here. Thank you for everybody coming here and supporting this event. I've had a great training camp, ready for this fight, looking forward to a real great show. Happy to be at Madison Square Garden. It's part of my dream, and it's a dream come true to be here on Friday night. I want to say thank you to Eddie Hearn and the Matchroom, Andrei Rybinski. Some of the best events in boxing right now are organized by you guys, and I really appreciate that it's possible to make these fights happen. And I look forward to, I thank my opponent, Michael Hunter, and I look forward to a great fight. On Friday, he'll understand what Russian willpower and character is all about.
Did you Madden, did you make that last bit up? Or did he actually say that? I never know. I liked it. I think we should do more of that. I think he's good. Now this man, last time I saw him, he was wearing a t-shirt and a pair of shorts at a press conference. I don't know what's happened, but all of a sudden, Michael Hunter's turning up looking like he's straight off of Wall Street. He looks $1 million, he's got a smile to light up the room. The other part of this brilliant, brilliant heavyweight fight on Friday night. Ladies and gentlemen, great amateur now, great cruiserweight now, great heavyweight, gunning for a shot at that world title. Ladies and gentlemen, Michael Hunter.
First of all, I'd like to thank my team. They've been a tremendous, tremendous big part of my career. Matchroom, The Zone, Eddie, David. You know, this is going to be a very big step up for me as far as being in the heavyweight division. I mean, the dude is bigger, he's stronger, he has a lot more experience than I do. But I took this fight knowing all this, and I just want to prove myself. You know, I've always tried to, you know, challenge myself to, you know, to the highest degree. So I know this is not going to be an easy fight. You know, the dude has tremendous, tremendous. He has over 200 amateur fights. You know, anybody with that much experience is, you know, is nobody to be, you know, looked over. So, like I said, I'm very prepared. And I just can't wait for the night to come. And I'm glad that I'm fighting at the theater. Hopefully we'll get on that Madison Square, that big stage. It's a tremendous blessing to be here. And thank you, New York. Appreciate you.
Thank you, both of you guys. You know what I love about that fight? It's crunch time, isn't it? For all the teams involved. I know how much each guy wants to win, but I know how much the teams want to win. That's the great thing about these three fights. They're a must win for all of these six fighters in these top three fights. I love that. Now we're going to bring up a young man who I like to think that I'm a great ambassador for women's boxing. This guy takes it to the next level. He tweets about women's boxing all day, and he's done a great job in making sure that women's boxing thrives, giving it the profile. And these two fighters really have done it all in women's boxing. This is for the WBO Featherweight Championship of the World. Two ladies out of Brooklyn, fearless, just a great, great fight and a great spectacle, not just for New York boxing, but for women's boxing. He's already here, the one and only Luda Bella.
Great to be here. I'm a lot I can say about this fight. I'm going to keep it brief because I figure now that Diamante thinks he has a microphone and he gives big speeches, and I got Shake Your Booty behind me, who's never short for words, Mr. Eddie Hearn, the great Eddie Hearn. This is a terrific women's fight. This is as good as it gets. These are the two best female fighters in New York. They have carried the torch and the banner for women's boxing in the city for years. It's a career high payday for them, but we're only beginning to crack the door open. I want to thank The Zone and Eddie for helping crack the door open, but it's time to knock the fucking door down. And that's what we have to do. The paydays they're getting are solid paydays for women. But I love this card. This is a great boxing card. This is worthy of a monthly subscription. It is terrific from top to bottom. I'm really looking forward to the fight between Guzman and Hunter. It's a terrific heavyweight fight, really a fight between two guys at the top of their game. The main event, this kid right over here may very well be the best prospect in boxing. He's certainly one of the three best in my view. And he's a kid that's going to headline a lot of shows. But the reality is the fight that's gotten the most attention in this city, the fight that's gotten the most attention on social media, the fight that's gotten the most attention from the media in general is the fight between the two ladies. And that says a lot about what women's boxing can be, and I'm hoping to see more women's boxing on The Zone, and I'm hoping to see a platform, a streaming service, a network really embrace women's boxing as champions. You know, as champions for that sport. Because these women can only do so much to chip away at the glass ceiling. The glass ceiling needs to be broken. I'm not saying that women's boxing is ever going to be as significant or as important or as popular as the men. the women in fairness, and they want equality. They're not going to get equality, but they deserve fairness, and they deserve fairness now. And this is a step in the right direction, and these women are both trailblazers, and I'm proud to have promoted Heather from the beginning of her career and to promoted Amanda through so many of her great accomplishments in boxing. These are two tremendous athletes. They're both going to throw down and give 110% on Friday night, and the world's going to see what the ladies can do in the ring. Amanda's wearing a Superman, Supergirl outfit. That's appropriate. 7 world championships in 7 weight classes is unheard of in boxing. Her credentials are already Boxing Hall of Fame credentials. And she's getting in the ring and she's going to challenge Heather Hardy for Heather's WBO title. Heather worked tirelessly to get that belt and went to another sport when she couldn't make enough bread to support herself and her daughter. Now she's back to boxing, she's getting a career-high payday. This, at least, is the way things are supposed to work. Amanda, you're a big favorite in the fight, but I know you've got a real fight ahead. This, I promise you, this lady to my right is going to deliver on Saturday, on Friday night. She's going to deliver everything she has in herself. She's going to lay it all out there, because if you look at women's boxing, as much as Amanda's been a pound-for-pound fighter, and Heather always reminds me, I never put her in that category, but I have started to, because I think you've earned your way into that top 10. But Amanda is, in my view, the Arturo Gatti, the Mickey Ward, the blood and guts warrior of women's boxing. And I think that is a tremendous compliment to pay to any fighter. I want to bring up Amanda to say a few words. I'm incredibly proud of her. I know she's going to perform at her best, as she always does, on Friday night. And I'm proud of both of these ladies, whatever happens on Friday night. My greatest hope for Friday night is they both perform to the best of their abilities, that the boxing fans, the public, the DAZN subscribers, and those tuning into DAZN see the best of women's boxing, and that both these elk ladies elevate themselves coming out of Friday night. And maybe just as importantly, because I know it's really important, unlike some of the women in women's boxing who are all about me, these ladies also understand that they're fighting for the women that follow them, and they're fighting to honor the women that preceded them. And my hope is that they both come out of this giving their best and in better shape than they did walking into the fight. Amanda Serrano.
Wow, if you don't support women's boxing after that speech, I'm out. But I'm so happy to be here again, fighting again. I love to fight, especially here in New York. I want to thank everybody who made this happen, Lou DiBella, Eddie Hearn, Matthew Boxing, the Zone, the media, for building up this fight to where it's at. My team, Team Serrano, Jordan, you know, if it wasn't for you, you wouldn't be here, for always pushing me, and definitely Team Hardy for taking the fight. As the WBO Super Champion, I have the privilege to challenge any of the champions. So of course, we look at all the champions, and we didn't want to fight for a vacant title once again, like all these girls do. They'd rather vacate their title than to fight me. So we chose Heather Hardy. No disrespect, Heather Hardy is as tough as they come, so we knew she wasn't going to back down on the fight. So that's why we chose Team Heat. And I'm ready. I trained really hard, and I know Heather Hardy trained really hard. So which only means that it's going to be 20 minutes, 10 rounds of non-stop action, which means that you guys are going to have a treat Friday night, and it's going to be a great night. And if you don't have if you can't go make it out to MSG, make sure you download the app, the Zone, so you can watch it there. It's going to be a great night of female boxing, and we're going to show that we deserve to be here, that we sell tickets. This fight sold it on its own, and it's going to be a hell of a fight. It's going to be Team Heat, Team The Real Deal, going at it for one thing, and that's for the title, and it's going to be a great night of boxing.
I noted that Heather's going to be defending her WBO title. This fight is also for the WBC interim title at featherweight. And it's also for, and I think this is sort of cool, it's for the Brooklyn belt, the Queen of Brooklyn belt. And that belt, I think this is Poetic Justice, sponsored by Madison Square Garden. So thank you to Garden for sponsoring the Queen of Brooklyn belt. I promoted this lady. She's the first woman I ever signed to a long-term promotional contract. I wanted to sign her from the first time I saw her fight, which was literally her pro debut, which was on a Broadway boxing card. She stole the show on that Broadway boxing card, and she stole the show so many times in her career by giving every ounce of guts and blood and tenacity that's in that attractive body. And she's a terrific fighter. She's a terrific person, like Amanda, a terrific person. And she deserves this opportunity. And it's my pleasure to bring up the reigning and defending WBO featherweight champion, Heather Hart.
Thank you, Will. Everybody said such good things. I don't even have to say nothing. I don't even know what's left to say. I've really become known as the girl who's always talking about the pay inequality, and I just want to take this opportunity to say, Lil, it's never a reflection of how grateful I am for where I am. Like, looking at the pictures yesterday in Madison Square Garden, like, crying with my mom, like, we did it, we're here, you know? So I'm just very grateful and very blessed, thankful that Amanda chose me. She's by far, pound for pound, probably arguably the best fighter that's out there right now in boxing and MMA, you know? But I'm ready. I'm the toughest girl I know.
Thank you, Amanda. Thank you, Heather. And thank you, Lou, as well. We move on to the main event, the WBC Interim World Lightweight Championship. This is such a great, great fight. You have on one side a very, very tough, big punching, undefeated Russian who has a great team of people around him that are completely convinced that they win this fight on Friday night. And on the other side, you have not just even a potential superstar, a superstar of boxing in Devin Haney. You have a guy that I believe has the ability to go on with multiple world titles and change the face of the sport of boxing to a young demographic, an energetic demographic with plenty of drive. He has everything to go on and become a superstar in the sport. But first, he must face by far the toughest test of his career so far. When I first met Devin Haney, you know, I saw the social media, you know, I saw the outfits, I saw that good-looking young kid, looked like he had it all. And sometimes you're a little bit worried about the work ethic or the mindset. It was only when I went to Las Vegas and I saw him train with Bill, who does such a great job with Devin, that I realized that it would never be the work ethic that would beat Devin Haney. It would only be another fighter. And as a promoter, when you're putting your heart and soul in a fighter, I can't tell you how great it is to know that that fighter is putting their heart and soul into their career as well. And they are just so disciplined, they've got the drive, you don't have to hound them, you know that day in, day out, they are working as hard as they possibly can to achieve their dream. And Devin and Bill have such a great mindset, such a great work ethic. Every young fighter should look at Devin Haney as the way to conduct yourself and to conduct your life and to go about your business. Work ethic's great, skill is also important. He has that, desire is also important. Zauer Abdullayev will test his desire, his skill, every inch of the way at the Mecca of boxing on Friday night. Firstly, we're gonna speak to the Russian team and I'm gonna bring up Alex Titov Jr. to introduce Zauer Abdullayev and say a few words. Ladies and gentlemen, Alex Titov.
My English is very limited, but thank you for helping me. Я понимаю, что Заур андердог в этом шоу, и даже русские букмекеры дают 13 к 1 на победу, на его победу. Но когда мы летели в самолете, отец напомнил мне историю 10-летней давности, когда мы точно так же летели в Америку, в Лас-Вегас, на бой Дмитрия Пирога с Дэниелом Джейкобсом. Вы, наверное, все хорошо помните этот бой и то, как он закончился. Дэнни Джейкобс был такой же проспект, как и Дэвин Хейни, а Дмитрий Пирог был такой же неизвестный русский парень, о котором никто не знал. Ситуация один в один похожа, прошло 10 лет. Зауру осталось просто повторить это. Спасибо.
I can translate, but I'm not as good as
to translate the whole that sentence. It was very long, so I'm just gonna say the meaning what Alex was trying to say. He said it's a very good fight. We really understand what even bookmakers in Russia giving chances to Haney about 12-1. But the situation reminds me like 9 years ago when we flew to United States with Dmitry Pirov and we fought Daniel Jacobs. And the results came out are completely different. Everybody was putting money on Daniel Jacobs, but we went with a knockout. Fifth round? Got that anyway? So you have a memory. He came out in a knockout in the fifth round. So the situation is very similar, so looking forward to Saturday fight, for Friday night fight, and thank you very much.
One of the two challenges for the vacant WBC interim world title, ladies and gentlemen, Zawa Abdullah.
Hello, assalamu alaikum. Спасибо всем большое, кто организовал этот бой. Я очень рад такой возможности боксировать в такой арене, как Madison Square Garden, главный бой вечером. Я очень долго ждал этой возможности такой, чтобы эту возможность для меня, чтобы проявить о себе. Да. И мы долго готовились к этому бою, за месяц-два до боя приехали в Америку и пошли очень хороший сбор. Мы очень хорошо подготовились, и в пятницу вечером собираемся заявить о себе и удивить всех вас, потому что меня здесь многие недооценивают. И в пятницу вечером мы заявим о себе, иншалла. Спасибо, thank you.
Салам алейкум.
I wanted to thank everybody who was helping to organize this fight. We had a very good preparation with my team. We came 2 months before this fight. We were preparing for the fight very, very hard. We are 100% ready to go. And a Friday night is going to be a good bout. Many people is underestimating me as a fighter, but we'll come on Friday night and we'll show what we have. Thank you very much.
And finally, a young man who needs no introduction. I think this is a big moment for him on Friday night at Madison Square Garden. I think this is exactly the kind of place that he should be boxing. 20 years of age, undefeated, 22-0, the number one ranked lightweight with the WBC. Ladies and gentlemen, Devin the Dream Haney.
I want to thank my team, my dad, Eddie Hearn, Matchroom, all the media that came out, Zara, I'm glad for accepting the fight. This is a huge opportunity for me. I'm happy to be here, especially in the Mecca of boxing. Friday night, I like to put on a great performance. He can compare me to Danny Jacobs, but no disrespect. This is a total different thing. I'm a total different monster than, you know, what happened 5 years ago, whatever. But, you know, I look to put on a great performance. This fight is going to put me one step closer to where exactly where I want to be. And, Igis, you know, I'm going to show you a little sample of what I'm going to get Lomachenko after that. I know Zara Abdullah is going to come. He's going to put on a great fight. He's going to bring his all. It's a lot at stake. But I'm ready. I had a great training camp. And come Friday night, I like to show the world, you know, who Devin Haney is, and you know that I'm ready for the top dogs.
Thank you, Devin Zawal, and thank you to everybody on the stage, and of course to the media that's come here today. We're gonna have the four head-to-heads up here on the stage. Everyone available to the media as well. Don't forget tomorrow, at 1 p.m. outside Madison Square Garden, the official weigh-in. And very limited tickets left for Friday night and Madison Square Garden, Hulu Theatre, and of course, if you can't get there, only one place to watch it. If you are a Fight fan and you don't have the zone, you are, as we say in England, a right plonker. Download it, let's go, let's have a great night. We'll see you on Friday night. Thank you very much.
Like you were doing.